Beamer.
Hi there.
Hi.
John Portman, that's Portman, but I do fit my mail on the city. 338 Country Club Road, number L136. I had to explain that to drivers last fall, the city of Jefferson, reviewing. I'm here tonight as president of the Walls Watershed Coalition. We come from the city of Jefferson, organization in this area. And since December, we also are known as Solana River Keeper and deal with the rivers all the way down the Gulf. Because one of the reasons that Walls was formed in 2012 is because of the wastewater situation. Because there were complaints coming all the way up from Citrus County and Eaton County. And you've already seen news about that.
Already seen news.
This is one example of, this is the fourth resolution that came so far from Florida County downstream. Now, I just add, when I say, I just like to say, I had nothing to do with putting about this, I had nothing to do with getting these resolutions passed. I'm just collecting them and talking to you about them tonight. And I can't, you know, read your minds, but it's pretty clear what we're talking about here. Just let me pick out that they're talking specifically about when the Florida Department of Health issues public health advisories. The secretary asked on page two, it results in warnings being posted on public access areas along rivers that are not safe for basically any use. That's a big problem in these counties downstream. The reason a lot of people live there is because of the Solana River. So, they all say Florida is stepping in order to do what? Well, I have a suggestion. I've heard about staff about how it's cleaner downstream from the wastewater plant than upstream. Okay. Well, what if the contamination is coming from some other source? What if the state of Florida, the institutes, pays for regular water quality monitoring, frequent, regular, not just when there's a spill and space them on the river so they can find out where this stuff is coming from? I would also recommend that Valdosta perhaps might consider having independent third-party water quality monitoring, independent as in not even as supervised by the city of Valdosta, so nobody's afraid of the dirty results that Valdosta doesn't like they might have a problem. So that's my suggestion for you tonight. And there's four of these that I've seen much like this. There's three more that either have been passed already.
All are up to 3 minutes, Reverend. I will answer one question.
Yes.
I know this might surprise you, but we are monitoring that situation continuously right now.
Mm-hmm.
And all it does is prove that we are right. The water that comes from the north end of the county is dirtier than the water that leaves the wastewater treatment plant here. Now, when that water gets to the county, to the state line down there, it's picked up, as you can imagine. Fertilizer, animal feces, and all that. And by the time it gets to the state line, it's dirtier than it is when it leaves our, much dirtier than when it leaves our plant. So we're doing everything we can, John, to make sure that we have all our information correct. And we're monitoring that situation on a continuous basis, not just when we have spills. So we'll be glad to furnish you with those facts today.
I understand that, and I thank you. However, they know you said it was fixed last summer and it still spills. You see the credibility issue.
We haven't had any spill. We had the one problem with the new plant. It was not our fault. If we spent $58 million on that plant and the people that designed it and built it were at fault and they correct it. So that's not the other problem.
I called your efforts. I'm just pointing out this credibility problem downstream. I may suggest
they might blame somebody.